If you receive an email you think is from your manager, colleague, vendor, or business partner, chances are you'll open it and do what it asks, especially if it's part of your regular job. Most of the time, these are all part of doing business. Unfortunately, a growing number of such requests are examples of business email compromise, BEC, or email account compromise, EAC. BEC and EAC have cost businesses upwards of $26 billion worldwide since 2016. And the average theft may net the attacker nearly $130,000, more than 30 times the average bank robbery. With BEC, cyber attackers pose as someone the recipient would trust. They may forge the sender and name fields in an email header, known as spoofing, or they may register a domain name that looks confusingly similar to one used by the individual they're impersonating. EAC attacks go further. Instead of just impersonating an email account, they take one over. Here's how they may steal our credentials. In a brute force attack, the attacker tries a username and password combination across many accounts until one works. In a breach replay attack, also known as credential stuffing, an attacker uses leaked credentials from one account on another one. This works because many people use the same password on multiple accounts. In credential phishing, the attacker gets account and password details by tricking the victim into handing them over. And in malware attacks, keyloggers and stealers can take and expose user credentials. Once they gain control of the account, they can launch all kinds of BEC-style attacks. BEC and EAC both target people and rely on social engineering, so they require a people-centric defense to prevent them. Learn more about BEC and EAC attacks and how you can stop them at proofpoint.com.